7,860 pounds. A very cool new middle bunkhouse has made landfall here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. And I like the layout, the shape, the look of this Cougar here. It gives us tons of door side windows, double awning coverage, 0 degree functionality with some nice 12 volt tank heaters, and a very, very uncommon quality in travel trailers. This is warranted for full-time RVing. Well, you can get to the front bedroom and the bathroom very much like the 34 TSB, which is another very popular big Cougar bunkhouse. With the slides closed, that's pretty much all you're getting to. It's very much a good destination use model, but I'm telling you, it's worth it when you get there. And the way they laid this out, basically just kind of a flip-flopped rear kitchen. A traditional rear kitchen has this big super slide and all these beautiful panoramic windows, typically on the driver's side. But this one puts like all the window coverage over here on the door side. And what that allowed for is some pretty creative use of a bunk room that has some good storage of its own. I mean, it's a Franken camper, but man, is it strong. Man, did it come together. So we're just going to start working our way around here. Up in the slide, you've got tons of lighting, and it's all on a dimmer switch. And what's kind of cool is all of these Cougars in their main slides have these wood slat blinds, which are nice because they kind of work like a pleated nightshade. But you got the little roller kind of post thing that'll, you know, turn the shades. You know what I mean, how it tilts the shades so you can block the light. But because they're just wooden, you can clean them, which is something that, like, cloth-pleated nightshades are not awesome for. It's hard to clean them. Now, what's kind of cool back here is, like, you have a defined middle living room, and then you have this defined kind of kitchen dining area. And what I think is neat about this floor plan, I don't think you have to have a family to want to like this camper. I think that it works for families, but I think that if you're a couple who has guests with frequency, or if you need a middle office or something like that, there's a lot of flexibility in this floor plan. It's more than just a bunkhouse. Like, it's cool that you have a nice little place you can sit back here, you can grab a bite to eat, you can visit with friends. There's storage below it. Of course, it folds down into a sleeper. But if we're going to talk about storage, we have to zero in on this epic rear kitchen here. It has so much prep space and storage, and I love that feature window on the rear wall there. And it's kind of cool because this RV, it looks and it feels large, even though there's only one slide here in the living area. And that's kind of what Cougar does. They bring bigger RV feels into a smaller, lighter weight segment, like 7,800 pounds. That ain't bad. That ain't bad for what we got here. Nice, deep, pocket-screwed overhead cabinets. I love the glass panel inserts. And that is a, like, full-accent splash wall across the rear wall there. You notice how the wall panel actually changes a little bit. If you're looking for easy-reach appliance outlets, I don't know if you could do much better than this. There's household outlets, USB plugs, everything right down low where the appliances are going to be, with just a football field's worth of prep space in this thing. Especially considering if you look at that recessed sink and stove, just the prep space here is phenomenal. And below all of that countertop space is nothing but cabinet space. The storage in this is just tremendous. But we're not done, because all that cabinet space is great, but if we're talking rear kitchen, you gotta have a pantry. And right next to that 8-cubic-foot fridge, we've got a big old pantry, wouldn't you know. It's kind of hidden around the corner, but it does just an awesome job. Now, the other thing this does very nicely is the living room arrangement, because if you look, that gigantic 4K HD TV is on Boardwalk and Park Place, directly across from our primary seating zone. And we have upgraded this one to feature a theater seat. Now, Cougar's kind of done something interesting here. It's a power theater seat, but it is still a manual recline, so that you're not necessarily, like, if you're dry camping and you only have 12 volt power available, you can still utilize the reclining function, which a household theater seat would not allow for. And I think this is part of the reason why the RV, even with only one slide in the living room, feels awesome, because it has these massive maximum size panoramic windows overlooking our campsite, which lets us really keep an eye on our kids. Plus, if you look forward a little bit, you see that the main entry door and the hallway both have their own handy little windows right there. Now, the TV is on an easy pivot. So, as if this wasn't already the perfect viewing angle, if you're standing in the kitchen and want to watch some TV, you can do it. And that setup right there is so, so handy. If you're sitting at the dining table grabbing a bite, or you're trying to get the kids to slow down and eat something, you know, you gotta bribe them with entertainment sometimes. Electric space heating fireplace below. And a cool thing on Cougars, these are actually 0 to 100 degree rated, less common in travel trailers and fifth wheels. There sure seem to be a lot of brands that want you to kind of think that way, but Cougar actually has tested it. Now, this is neat, because that's your converter panel right there, but they sort of built a seat top on it, and you see how you've got sort of like an entry area, kind of coat hook and hat and glove storage. It's cool how they handle this entry area. Speaking of which, you might have noticed how that light kind of dimmed out on us. This has welcome back lighting. You got a motion light right here. You have another one of these in the pass-through right above the in-command system, by the way. So you can just turn it hard on, hard off, but you can also leave it on motion mode like that. And remember that nice viewing window in the entry door we talked about? If that light was on all the time, it'd collect a nice old nest of bugs, a big old cloud of gnats outside the window. You're not going to have that happen this time. Now, all Cougars have in-command, which can let us run our lights, slides, awnings, all that stuff. My battery's getting low. I thought the light should be brighter than this. My battery must be dimming out on me. And you can also operate your heating and cooling, and anything you can do off this panel, you can do right off your phone as well. So if you're laying in your master bedroom, or if you're back here in the kitchen and you're cooking up a storm, you're like, man, I'll tell you what else I'm cooking. I'm cooking my brains out. I'm sweating to death over here. Well, you thankfully can just grab your phone and adjust the temperature controls. And here it is. I probably should have started here, since anytime we're talking a middle bunk or a bonus room, that's kind of the point. And I like how they made it more than just a bunkhouse with that trifold sofa here and the folding bunk above it. Now, when it's all opened up, that trifold, it uses up every bit of the space, but what's cool about it is if you have big kids or adults, this is not just a little kid bunkhouse, and, even if it was, you could just leave the sofa folded up and have a top bunk folded down over the bottom bunk. Just take the back cushions off the sofa bed, and you're going to be good to go. But they didn't just stop there. One of the cool things you might have noticed, how when it is, like, daytime, this bunk gets right up out of the way, and you've got a couple gas struts, which make it a one-hand, easy lift kind of scenario. The USB plugs right there are a nice little touch. And if they would have just stopped with the sofa and the bunk, it would have been good enough. But they didn't. They cranked it up to 11. Normally, in Cougar RVs, when the TV's across from the theater seat like that, the TV pivots out in their storage behind it, and I call it a pantrytainment center. But they didn't do that this time, because the kitchen already had plenty of storage. So instead what they did, this space behind the TV and next to the pantry is a large closet. Frankly, I think this is a larger closet and dresser space than what you have available in the master bed. Across from the sofa, we have TV hookups here. But like I said, it's useful for more than just sleeping, and I love the storage. The storage is, to me, what makes it. It's great. It made it from just a neat floor plan to a stellar model. You have this handy little kind of, it could be a little corner desk nook or something over here, but they didn't just leave it bare. They did something with it, and that's what I like about Cougar. That's why I call them the Ultralight Plus brand. With the power vent fan and that big skylight and that clear shower surround door right there, the bathroom looks and feels large, light, and bright. You've got the same sealed edge countertops here that you have back in the kitchen, and you can also see, in addition to that easy step-in shower, you have full storage below the sink, so ideal for things like big waste baskets that a lot of travel trailers don't offer. And by the way, that is a porcelain foot flush stool. And just like in the bunk room, if there was a little space, if there was a blank wall, they did something with it. They didn't waste anything. And having that dedicated linen space in here, room for towels, room for your extra body washes and stuff, it's just absolutely awesome. You can see how it is a dual entry bed and bath, although obviously we have doors here for privacy. Here's a better look at those wooden slat blinds I was telling you about that I couldn't get the words out earlier. Neat thing on all Cougars, and frankly, it's more of a Keystone thing than just a Cougar thing. All of their doors are like a fully framed out 3-inch thick door. They're all studded out so that the door stays square no matter what. What that means in English is when you're towing down the road and you hit a chuck hole, the door isn't going to bang open against something else. Up front here, these are 50 amp service. So They are standard 50 amp. They're always going to be second air ready. The one that we're looking at today doesn't happen to have the second air conditioner. We may have one in stock that does. We often will build the same floor plan multiple different ways here at Haylett RV, so you can kind of zero in on exactly what you're looking for. Now that front windshield, kind of like the rear kitchen window, it's awesome in the light and the visibility and just the feel that it gives us. It helps tie into that larger look and feeling thing that Cougars do. But when I point the camera right at it, it's just not real friendly with me. What's cool is all Cougar trailers have a 70 by 80 king bed, just like a fifth wheel that you could option the king bed into their big fifth wheels, or like a Montana. You've got a Montana bed here in a travel trailer floor plan. Kind of like the rear kitchen wall was accented, the front wall is also accented. You see household and USB plugs on both sides of the bed. There is a storage chest under the bed, like the bed does easy lift up. And a neat thing here, of course you have TV hookups directly across from the bed. But with InCommand, you could grab your phone to turn on the lights. You could walk over that panel to turn on the lights, but you don't have to, because what's nice is in the bedroom and back in the living room, next to those outlets back there, there are still cabin-sensitive light switches. So that switch back there will activate all the ceiling and kitchen lights in the living area. Kitchen lights in the living area? You know what I meant. And then this switch is just the bedroom. So you don't have to be any kind of techno wizard. You still have just normal switches, which is sometimes kind of nice anyway, even if you are a techno wizard. And since the bed's so darn big, you kind of benefit from an expanded pass-through storage, and you can see big doors on both sides. We'll peek in at what's over there around the corner in just a second. First, a quick peek at the InCommand here. I like to point out how it's shielded, but if you're not familiar with InCommand, we've done total separate videos on that. One of the nice things about the panel out here is all of the wiring is color-coded, so there seems to be more factory accuracy when that is being done, not to mention the fact I don't think since they went to InCommand we've really had any Cougar wiring issues, but theoretically if we did, it'd be much easier to track down since it's all color coded and goes through one consistent hub. The big baggage doors there are nice, thick, heavy, which is going to help prevent heat and cooling loss from spilling out under that king bed. And up front here in that painted nose cap, we have that automotive inset windshield, which has really just become kind of Cougar's identity. You see the glorious light of the heavens shining down upon it there as we walk around. Either that or that's just the normal sunshine that takes place at this time of day. moving on. I do like the updated color package on here, and that in conjunction with some things like the radiant barrier package, the insulation package, and the shift to the white roof skin and the attic vents is going to make this not just a good cold camper, but a hot season camper as well. And that's kind of what's cool about these Cougars. You know, 7,860 pounds, considering the size and what feels like the bulk and heft of this RV, 7,860 is not bad. And that's really testament to how well they're accomplishing their goals. Cougar's not trying to be the lightest trailer out there. Their goal is to be an ultralight plus. They want big RV features and trying to bring it as close to they can in a smaller, lighter class. Obviously, it's a long floor plan, but if you look at what you get in this, you have to usually go much, much bigger. They were very crafty and creative in their designs. So some of the things they do different here is the 12-volt tank heating pads and the shift back to standard auto leveling on all Cougar trailers and fifth wheels, with the exception of the little 22-foot Cougar trailer, because it's simply not large enough to even accept a full auto leveling system. Now, these are hot, cold, camp rated, 0 to 100 degree, whatever you want to call them. You've got an enclosed heated belly with a radiant barrier, 12-volt heated hold tanks, extra large furnace. And when they went to that generation is when Cougars all became full-time RV warranted, which in fifth wheels isn't common, but in travel trailers, it's basically unheard of. I don't know of another brand of travel trailer that offers a full-time warranty like a Cougar does, and I think that says a lot about them. These are side solar ready, but also roof solar prepped, which is the box on the right. The left is our auto leveling system, and down below, handy little battery disconnect switch so that our battery is not going to be subject to some parasitic load and decay in storage mode. Simple little docking center right here, but primarily this is going to be used as your, you got your side solar prep as well as your little outside shower right there. It's funny, it's such an oddball looking floor plan from the outside. All you see is one smaller slide over here, and this is the side of the RV that is usually just peppered with slide outs. So it has, it's just unconventional. Maybe that's why I like it. I like weird and unconventional. I like it and just unusual. Has a 2-inch receiver hitch on the back, which is perfect if you want to be able to bring along a bike rack or like a little portable generator. You can put a little tray on the back there. Backup camera ready, and this does have reverse lighting built into those taillights. So when you are getting backed into your campsite, you're less likely to start playing bumper cars, because when that happens, everybody loses. You may have noticed you have amazing patio coverage on this. You have dual power awnings, both easy tilt, LED lighting, all the jazz, you know, everything you expect. All our windows are tinted. And how about the perfect little campsite kid watch and panoramic viewing scenario here, as you have those maximum size windows wrapped all the way around the door side of this RV, plus a full viewing window in the door, hallway window, and bedroom window. The whole side of this thing is just peppered with them. The door is anti-slam, so the kids can't fling it open. Extra large handle and the Moride stable steps make for some easy come and go in and out of the RV. That in conjunction with the auto leveling system, one of the benefits of auto leveling is it is, as Bob Seger would say, it's like a rock when you get to your campsite. You put those jacks down, it just, the trailer just doesn't move. And one of the things that's kind of cool about these Cougars, with that double vaulted roofing arched inside and outside, they are so load bearing. It feels super stable, super steady up here. You don't feel any sort of buckle under your feet. Up between the bedroom and bathroom ceiling vents, you've got our roof solar prep. And then you've got these white hockey puck jobs. There's two of these on this floor plan here. Those are attic vents. So the gap between the roof decking I'm walking on and the interior ceiling panel is what we call the attic in the RV business. And normally it's just a hot box. It's an oven and it's holding all that heat and it's trying to bake your brains out from the top down, basically. But this lets an immense amount of that heat out. They took one of those little heat laser jobs and they shot it on the inside of their ceilings down in Texas, and they were finding that those things were broiling at like 130 degrees. They put these attic vents on and the temperature dropped to like 85. Just because the air could finally escape. Hot air rises, so it organically bleeds out, especially with that vaulted roof. All the hot air tends to pool up in the top center part of the ceiling, which naturally that's where that's located, and it lets all that heat out. So that in conjunction with, like I said, insulation package, thicker 2-inch walls, radiant barriers, bigger air conditioner standard, etc. It's an awesome hot, cold camper. I think it's an awesome floor plan. I've wanted to try to figure out how could we come up with a rear kitchen middle bunkhouse, because middle bunkhouses have been done and they're very cool, they're very successful, but can we do it different? And I could never figure out a way, but maybe that's why I'm here and Cougar's doing what they do on top of their game. So give us a call here at Haylett RV. We do hitching, pieces, parts, trades, finance, truck and trailer package deals, RV delivery, and everything between. Basically everything with the exception of hidden dealer fees. We do it all, guys. So take care, stay safe, have fun. Happy camping, everyone. Give us a call, and you can be like all those trailers back there that are sold and just waiting to be picked up. That's the kind of volume we crank out of Haylett RV.